I am Exogiant and going to be arguing DC Comics Halloween Spirit Defender other forms of media. Since all the other holidays have a mascot, Halloween should have a mascot, and a DC character no less. Exogiant, I'm going to be saying how you can do a DC Halloween's puzzle for everyone. You need to do a Dream of the Endless, putting Jack Pumpkinhead into the real world, combining with the Samhain from the dream world that he got from some kid's nightmares. As of Samhain. Then the Teen Titans would use him to get into a criminal circus. Then them defeating a headless watchman, a witch, the Bigfoot. Just for them getting him into hell where he'll belong with other monsters.
It would be the Teen Titans specifically because of them having a member called Jack-O-Lantern. And them needing to do it like this because of one of their supervillains being a monster theme them going up against. And because him already knowing them, so they need someone who wasn't already a member of the Teen Titans and who was already a monster. Spoiler's connection to the red, him already knowing the Sandman, so them just borrowing him from the Sandman. Also need to do him possessing Blue Devil and him becoming a monster and attacking people. Him going against people. It needs to be Blue Devil because of him always suffering from being turned into a demon. Same costume from the DC Halloween cover. I'm wanting to make this picture. I'm basing it on that Halloween spirit, not the Teenage Girl Halloween spirit. Because you shouldn't get anything from that terrible show. And him possessing Blue Devil, him being known as the Halloween spirit, him having the same costume from the comic book cover. And with him being more of a shape of a monster, and with his skin being jet black. Because of it being an evil version of him being blue, and it wouldn't be racist if you just don't give him the red lips. But after the defeat Blue Devil possessed by the Halloween spirit and do an exorcism on him, then being able to get the Halloween spirit out of Blue Devil. The Halloween spirit could still possess Blue Devil on occasion, and him being his definitive of guy he possesses, but only for it being for a good reason. And it just being because on occasion him being more powerful if he possesses someone. And him needing to possess Blue Devil specifically because of him liking Blue Devil as a host because of how Blue Devil became a demon. Then for how he'd look whenever he's not possessing Blue Devil. He would be a floating cloak with skeleton hands and a pumpkin head, but with a black spirit coming out of the rest of his body and an orange flaming spirit coming out of his pumpkin head. With black flaming eyes coming out of his jack-o'-lantern eyes. And with big spirit claw hands coming out of his skeleton hands. With people using need to summon him in the DC universe by doing an ancient ritual, it's only the magic characters would know. And with him still being a good person, if you don't let him out of the jack-o'-lantern, you're keeping his spirit in, because if you destroyed his pumpkin head, it would let out his spirit, then he would get power mad and him becoming evil again. Him being able to do a rest of a spirit body from the jack-o'-lantern pumpkin head. And him only getting the other body when you letting him out of it, and there also being an ancient ritual to get him back into the jack-o'-lantern and to send him back to his own dimension. But if you don't let him out, he can go back to his own dimension the way he wants to. And with him still feeding on people's fears, and if people are still scared of him, they're not being able to do anything against him, but if them being able to face their fears, them being able to do things against him, it explains the Halloween traditions because it making kids brave so them becoming the costumes that feed him and his monster of horrors. Also trying to scare people on purpose because of him wanting to get out of the pumpkin head on purpose, but him also knowing how important it is him staying in the pumpkin head and him also liking being in the other body too. Halloween to last forever and for it to be night all the time. Him also going up against Krampus and him being the enforcer of what you're supposed to do at Halloween. The reason the Halloween spirit is doing this is because of the way he looked, people treated him badly and didn't trust him when he wanted to play with them. So because of them already being scared of him, he thought he didn't have anything to lose if he became the monster that they already thought of him as. Halloween for the humans. Then you would do the rest of his origin story. He could show up to try to protect his holiday and to try to take over other holidays. Him especially going after Christmas because of him hating that everyone loves Christmas more than Halloween. He can even be a villain to Santa specifically in the DC universe. They would defeat him in the end, but then John Kent and Damon Wayne returned back into a good guy just by being good to him and by not judging a book by its cover. He also saw it for demons and monsters trying to get rid of him so they can become the spirit of Halloween so they can use Halloween to take over the world. You can also use him to have a bunch of the Universal monsters in the DC Universe. Also trying to save Halloween. You'd see the effect of the Halloween spirit being in the DC Universe would have on the rest of the DC Universe and what everyone else is doing at the time. And what everyone else is doing at Halloween at the time and what everyone else is fighting against monsters at the time. Creature Commandos is a military team in DC comic books that's made out of monsters. These guys do a cartoon show about them in the DCU. I will be saying how we could do that, but me also saying my own ideas for how they can do a cartoon show for the Creature Commandos. You just need to throw in that them combining Inaki with Frankenstein along with his usual origin story, with him having an alien villain of his own, and Frankenstein already being back together with the bride. He is a monster hunter in DC, and he does have a good relationship with Batman in the DC universe. And Sage is not just a cheap knockoff of Sealed, but you could make it the DC Universe's version of Sealed. And with the Creature Commandos working together with the Sage part of the government, Steve usually calling the Creature Commandos freaks, and him being the actual metaphorical monster, with the Creature Commandos actually being good people, with him treating the Creature Commandos badly and him not caring about them, but then him starting to care about them later on in the show. Then they would find out that he's not calling them freaks because of him hating them, him calling them freaks because of him liking them. So, and him also treating them badly because of him being jealous of them for being special. But he would become a better person, and by finding out him being pretty special himself, and him also starting to care about the Creature Commandos in the end. With him having a daughter in the later seasons of the show, and her becoming a monster hunter and a member of the Creature Commandos with him. That wants to be human, but him finding out that he's more human than he thinks. With him becoming a robot in the end, and with him also being a good soldier in it. Medusa would have turned herself into a monster randomly, so her being able to help the Creature Commandos. And you'd also need to put a lot to focus on her being the team's doctor in general. And with the full costume she wore with the mask. The vampire of the team would have been offered a full pardon and for a crime he didn't do if he did it. With him really used to being a criminal, but a criminal with a good heart. With him not wanting to do the right thing, but him being the moral guide for the team. And he would have been created by injecting him with a modified man-bat serum also made from Mexican vampire bats. And by using magic and science and a DNA sample from Dracula. The werewolf would have already had the sympathy and him joining them under the promise of them helping him with it. But after them using magic and science, injecting him with a werewolf serum, getting him bitten by a werewolf, and exposing him to a supercharged moon, he becomes a werewolf permanently. He would struggle with his werewolf tendencies, but in the end he would start to love being a werewolf. Starter would have been honored that her father became a member of the Creature Commandos fighting against Nazis, so her turning herself into a girl woman, so her being able to fight with the Creature Commandos. With her just being honored to be a member of the Major Creature Commandos. For the mummy, you would explore him being a doctor for the team too, and him always helping with the Medusa doctor with her surgery. Each season would go through each generation of the DC Universe. The first season would have them crossing over with the Golden Age characters and be based on the Golden and Silver Age. The second season would be based on the 80s and 90s, and it being and them crossing over with the 80s and 90s characters who were iconic at the time. The last season would be based on the modern comic books and them crossing over with the most iconic DC superheroes in the modern day. The Lieutenant Treve aging throughout the years, but him still being able to be part of their government. And now we combine the animation style of the Drac Pack with the way they look in the DC Creature Commandos showcase with the DC Showcase Creature Commandos with the way they look in Batman the Brave and the Bold. And for the Monster Mash being the opening theme song for the show, with the Creature Commandos killing Nazis for the visual, so it being like a music video. And each end credit of each different episode being a different horror theme song, with it being in big red letters and there being a music video going on there. With the Creature Commandos doing something different in each music video end credit, and it going along and it being according to each different horror song. With it being the most iconic horror songs, it going along with the themes of the episode, then using the four original versions of these songs. Because if James Gunn can do an opening credits good, then and a bunch of people can do a closing end credits, it seemed good too. For James Gunn's DCU Creature Commandos, you can keep the animation sound the same, and there would still be Amanda Waller's new Suicide Squad doing missions for her. Because after James Gunn's last Suicide Squad, the Suicide Squad being too well known to do undercover missions now. But then still doing the heartwarming emotions and in the R-rated comedy of the Suicide Squad. But it being about them going to do undercover work specifically and them also going up against other DC characters in the DC Universe. You would do Reza like how he was done in the Suicide Squad movie, just him not dying in it and them also finding out his origin story and him also being the crazy guy of the group and him also being the first one to kill a bunch of guys from them. The human media would feel bad that Rick Flag died and it being because of Amanda Waller, so him starting to go against Amanda Waller with the rest of the Creature Commandos. In the first season, the Bride and Frankenstein would already be broken up. In the second season, they would be healing their relationship, and in the third season, they would get back together. And here, the Gilman inherited being a fisherman from her father, the Gilman, but her also doing some upgrades with the serum, so her being able to help the Creature Commandos even more, and her being even more of a fisherman now. And G.I. Robot would have the personality of a soldier and a robot, with him also being more human than your usual military soldier, and with him just wanting to make sure they're winning the war against people. With them saying two episodes of it at a time, and with each episode being a 20-minute episode. They're only having 3 seasons, and there being 20 episodes in each season. The rest of the Creature Commandos would be immortal because of them being monsters. They would be frozen into the modern day after World War II ended, and it actually being because of them by them winning World War II. So because of them being frozen and the government lying about them is why they wouldn't want to work together with the government again, but after it, Lieutenant Shriver convinced him to work for the government again and work for the safe part of the government, surviving into the modern day. It would also be good if they crossed over a bunch of the other wartime heroes from the DC Comic Books Company, like Sergeant Rock and the Justice Society and the Freedom Fighters. You'd also need the Haunted Tank in there because of them being so similar. The Haunted Tank is a ghost of a US president, so he would be good in modern days, saying about the modern version of America. And he does also have an awesome weapon with his tank. And he does have DC Comics version of the Ghostbusters, so you can make it them being a superhero version of the Ghostbusters. And because the Doom Patrol is more than just a cheap knockoff of the X-Men, especially since they came first before the X-Men, and because of them being the world's strangest superheroes, and because they were one of the best works of one of the best comic book writers, Grant Morrison, and because of them having a great supervillain rogues gallery, they really should get their own cartoon show. Season they would have the original Doom Patrol members and them going up against the Brotherhood of Evil with the original Brotherhood of Evil members. With it being in a similar style and tone to the original Teen Titans show, with it being a perfect combination of goofy and lighthearted but also dark and serious and yet also bright and hopeful. I mean, since that would be a perfect combination of DC Showcase and the original Teen Titans Show animation styles. To really show and get the perfect feeling of the original Teen Titans Show of it being a perfect combination of goofy and lighthearted, but also dark and serious and bright and hopeful. I actually hate the Doom Patrol live action show because of it actually ruining the Doom Patrol. I mean, I hate that people think that's what the Doom Patrol is, so they really should it be a cartoon show so they am knowing how good the Doom Patrol actually is. The Doom Patrol are good people and are a family who really want to help people, but the live action show doesn't show that at all. And the Doom Patrol really are heroes, but the live action show pretty much ruins them. Also, in the first season, they'll find out the Chief created the situations for them to become the Doom Patrol because of him accidentally creating the brain from the Brotherhood of Evil. But eventually, they would forgive him because if he didn't do that, they never would become a family, and them eventually becoming a family in the end. Madame Rouge has shape-shifting powers and has stretchy powers. She is ruthless and she is one of the brain's best members of the Brotherhood of Evil. She is Elastigirl's arch nemesis in the Doom Patrol. They call her Madame Rouge because she likes tricking people or by using her stretchy powers to shapeshift into other people by tricking them. The Brain is just that, a brain, and he is a French criminal mastermind, and he is also a mad scientist. He was so smart that another mad scientist, now his cousin of the Doom Patrol, grew jealous of him and arranged a little accident. Fortunately for the Brain, he had a super intelligent gorilla that he created to save him. Monsieur Mallet is the Brain's most loyal member of the Brotherhood of Evil. He is the most civilized gorilla because of him and quoting literature and Shakespeare and with him knowing more than one language. He is also armed to the teeth with weapons and wears a French red beret. You should also fill the show up with a bunch of the Golden Age supervillains from the Doom Patrol covers. Invincible Mirror Man is one of the Doom Patrol's most iconic villains and he is an extremely powerful villain of the Doom Patrol. You can just make it that now his cousin from the Doom Patrol tried to experiment on him to make him a member of the Doom Patrol, but the Brain managed to stop it and tell Animal Vegetable Mirror Man about it. And he said that he would get Animal Vegetable Mirror Man his revenge on the Doom Patrol, but only if him joined the Brotherhood of Evil. The show would only have 3 seasons, they would show 2 episodes at a time, and each episode would be 20 minutes long, and each season would have 20 episodes. In the second season, them dealing with Dr. Time. To make it after him stealing Clark King's mask, him being able to bring people's bad memories to life. To make it more original from the other time villains and to make it so people don't call him a cheap knockoff of the Clock King. In the last season you would do the Fifth Horseman Extinction. Because that was a perfectly good and serious villain of the Doom Patrol and they ruined him in the live action show by making him a giant cockroach that kissed a giant rat. Season the original Doom Patrol members would die, then in the second season you would get the Doom Patrol that came after them and everyone dealing with their deaths. And in the last season the original Doom Patrol members would come back to life and them being happy about it and them also doing the modern Doom Patrol members in the third season. And everyone else was doing it Halloween at the time and where everyone else was fighting against monsters at the time. Then you'd follow the storyline of Are You Afraid of the Dark Side, but the storyline's actually happening in it. With Harley Quinn needing to set Bloody Mary for Darkseid, Batman dealing with someone's in the backseat with the Mad Hatter, scariest stories to tell in the dark, Jon Stewart facing his worst fears in space, the Phantom Stranger taking people through an infinite staircase throughout time and space throughout the multiverse, Aquaman dealing with a sea monster, and Aqualad fighting against his barber, the supervillain Black Manta, and Aquaman becoming a sea monster, but Aqualad saving him, Wonder Woman and Vixen stopping some demon children in Vixen's home village in Africa, Superman and Lois fighting an alien invasion of parasite. I'll leave a link in the description below saying what would happen in the rest of the story, but this would be the main part of this story. And Superman saving a bunch of kids from him, and in the end it would turn out they're actually being a monster. Superman and Martian Manhunter would go to hell to stop Doomsday from coming back to life. A bunch of the people that we see in hell would only be there because of the devil conning them in a deal, so the loved ones wouldn't die in it. But because of Superman, Martian Manhunter, and inspiring hope in them, the ones who were conned by the devil went up to heaven, and a bunch of them stopped Doomsday from coming back to life. And it also managed to inspire hope in Supergirl and Martian Manhunter, that they managed to inspire hope in Hal, and also that those people met needed to help them stop Doomsday from coming back to life. See Bloodwing being the Superman of Hal, and him being a different person than Martian Manhunter this time. With him also saving the demons who aren't evil in Hal, and him also making sure that the devil doesn't torture anyone they only conned into being in Hal. Not anyone who ended up in Hal because of them themselves being evil, and going to Hal because of them being bad when they died. With him still being a part of the Super Family, and him still helping them in the real world. Do the storyline of Night Terrors, but this time Dr. Destiny would be working together with Insomnia as his mentor, and to take over the DC Universe and turn the real world into nightmares, and then doing it to bring the superheroes' fears to light. The Superman facing his fear of the world of being destroyed, and it turned out the Arca family being unaffected by it because of them having Atlantean magic, and Supergirl would also help Superman get out of his fears. Then Wonder Woman would face her fear of becoming a Power Man God, and she would help the Justice League Dark get out of their nightmares. And we can also see Paradise Island being affected by it, and Wonder Woman's sister facing her fears too. Also see Satana trying to protect the Justice League Dark, while them being stuck in their nightmares. She did a spell to get someone who was still awake, but the only other one who was still awake was Robot Man because of his brain being covered by metal. He would be turned into a nightmare, but then Satan would change him back and get rid of the other nightmares. Power Girl would face her worst fears and wake up right next to her girlfriend and find out that it wasn't a dream and her need to stop the real nightmare in real life. Then we'd see the rest of the Super Family needing to fight against Cyborg Superman and an Apocalyptic Superman, and then needing to face their worst fears, defeat Mongo, and then managing to wake up from it. See Wally West save the Flash from his worst fear. Then see how Jordan face his worst fears, and so why he's the Green Lantern, and why it being a Green Lantern means you overcoming moments of great fear. And him using his real power to wake up from the nightmare, and him using his real power to defeat his fears. Also see Sinestro face his fears and find out that he is still all good at being a supervillain, and him actually being glad to be a supervillain, and that he doesn't want to become a Green Lantern again, and that he's actually glad being a Yellow Lantern. Then Mary Marvel would try to face her fears, but then she would find out that she doesn't need to face it alone, and she would get the rest of her family in them. Then not only would she wake up, her also getting rid of the nightmares of the rest of her family too. With her finding a Black Adam version of Captain Marvel. And Black Adam would defeat his fears, but that would be the time when Batman going to get him. Then the Arrow family would face their fears, and Arsenal would be reunited with his daughter. Then he would see Nightwing's worst fear as him killing Batman. Then he would work together with Scarecrow to get out of Arkham Asylum, and him also setting the rest of the Bat family free too. Then we'd see the Teen Titans help each other and help them get out of each other's fears, and they would also help the Titans Tower face its fear. And they would also find out that not all they are is pain, in fact it being the opposite, actually. Then Rose Wilson would save a kid version of herself from the murder man and her demon version of her family. And with her also finding out that she's actually glad how her life turned out, and her actually being grateful for it, because if it didn't happen like that, she wouldn't be the person she is today, and she wouldn't be able to know her Barbara Deathstroke. Batman finally faces fear of his parents dying. Then we'd see the kid version of Bruce Wayne be glad and be happy that he became Batman. Then it turned out Insomnia is looking for the Nightmare Stone, so they would bring Sandman back to life to get the Nightmare Stone first, but then Insomnia would get the Nightmare Stone first, and them also finding out Insomnia's origin story. Then Dr. Destiny would manipulate reality to send the Teen Titans and the Justice League to other parts of the multiverse, and them need to get their way back there. They would go to the Justice League of Monsters world, where the Justice League is each a different kind of monster, and them turning the rest of the world into different kinds of monsters. And them helping the Teen Titans defeat them so the world would be cured of it. continuing from the Batman Draco series universe, and it, the same stuff happening from DC vs. Vampires and DC Deceased. War of the Undead Gods, and then also defeating Erebos as DC's Cthulhu in it. DC needs a Cthulhu because of Marvel having so many of them, and Erebos would be hurt because of him being the physical embodiment of Anti-Life, the thing Darkseid just saw his whole life after. Get stuck in the mansion of the Justice League has been combined with the Teen Titans, and every other DC character has been combined with every other DC character, but then they would get out of that one too. Then they would get stuck in the Batlanterns universe, where a bunch of superheroes have been combined with a bunch of other superheroes. Then they would get stuck in the Dark Knights of Steel part of the multiverse, and then getting out of that one. Then a bunch of Batman servants would work together to try to kill Batman, but then Dream would stop Death from taking Batman's soul. Because Batman striking fear into hearts of criminals and inspiring hope in the good people of Gotham City. So Batman surviving it and Death going along with it because Dream is family. Get back to the main part of the multiverse in the DC multiverse. They would use Deadman and the Dream Stone to defeat Dr. Destiny and Insomnia. And you'd also need to make it Dr. Hate also combine the Chaos Amulet with the Nightmare Stone. You also need to make it Dr. Hate being a combination of Dr. Chaos's Helmet of Chaos from S3's dimension, the Crime Syndicate's world, and Dr. Fate's Helmet of Order from the main DC universe in the multiverse.